This is a really difficult question to answer. In fact, it's a question that scientists have been trying to answer for hundreds of years. And there's a really nice story, though we're not sure how true it is, about a scientist called Sir Isaac Newton, who was around about 400 years ago. And he was thinking of this very same question while sitting outside under his apple tree one day, when an apple fell from the tree and landed on his head. And that got him thinking. Why did the apple fall down onto his head? Why didn't the apple fall sideways? Or why didn't the apple float off into space? And the answer, of course, was gravity. This invisible force that pulls things together. An apple has its own gravitational pull, but so does the entire Earth. And it's Earth's gravitational pull that's holding us down on the ground right now. He also wrote about how different things have different amounts of gravity, and that all depends on their size. For example, an apple is quite small, so it doesn't have very much gravity. But the Earth is much bigger than me or than an apple, so it has a lot more gravity. Isaac Newton's idea of gravity was fine, until Einstein came along. Einstein realized that Isaac Newton's idea of gravity didn't work if something was very heavy, like a black hole, or if something was traveling really fast, like a rocket. So Einstein improved upon Isaac Newton's idea with his theory of general relativity. And we use our telescopes here at Jodrell Bank to see if Einstein was right about gravity, or see if that needs improving as well. So we've got a good guess of how gravity works, but we're still not entirely sure.